everybody, it's me Adele and welcome to my channel Sew for Serenity, where I talk to you about my sewing journey. Welcome back if you're a regular viewer, and if you're new here, I hope you enjoy this vlog and you consider subscribing. Now firstly, I need to apologise if you can hear fireworks in the background. There are fireworks going off. It's Friday the 3rd of November and I don't know about you, people started setting off fireworks on Wednesday and I suspect they will continue to go on till Wednesday next week as well. So I'll try and edit it out, but I can't promise. The other thing I need to apologise for is the lighting. I'm hoping this is going to come across okay. My camera does have good lighting, but I am filming this at night time. Now the nights are getting darker and I've had such a busy week this week, I literally have no time to film unless it's at the evenings. So I've just been today to the Creative Craft Show. And I wanted to jump on so I could show you what I purchased and get this edited or queued up to be edited. Now, because it's Christmas craft show, I thought I'd wear my Christmas hoodie. I mean, it's November, right? We can start doing that. So this is my Christmas hoodie that I purchased this fleece fabric from Sew Brum last year. And I made, I don't even know what, this is just the Lekker Patterns men's hoodie that I just adapted for the fleece. But this fleece I got from Sew Brum last year and I just used a little bit of Sherpa that I had on the hood and it's just so cozy. Now they actually have this fabric in stock at First Fabrics, so if you want to get some of this, I'll pop a link in below to show you where that is. And yeah, it's such a good quality fleece. So if you're looking for a Christmas fleece and you want to recreate this jumper, head over and check it out. So back to the Creative Craft Show. So the Creative Craft Show is at the NEC. It's half of the show is craft and the other half is Christmas related gifting. So it's not really a dressmaking, sewing, knitting, crocheting as such. It's just all crafts and Christmas gifts. It's only £8.40 for a ticket. And because there was quite a few people from our social sewing that were going, they were making a day of it. So I decided I was going to book the day off work and go. And Becky came from What Beck Sews and also Shannon from the Sewing Warehouse. I've been in London all week. I was back at work yesterday and then today went to the Creative Craft Show. So that explains why, God knows when I'm going to publish this vlog, but that'll explain why there's been a bit of lacking of vlogs from me lately. So I wanted to jump on. Alice is just being put to bed by her dad and I just thought I'd jump on and show you what I purchased. Now, the Creative Craft Show, as I said, is very much, not necessarily sewing related, but there were a few fabric shops there. A few new ones that I hadn't actually heard of or come across before, and that was exciting. Now, I did go to the show in my head saying, don't buy loads of fabric, because over here is a big pile of fabric that I purchased at Sew Brum. If I can have done the vlog, I will link it up here. If I haven't filmed it yet, I won't. Put it all up here at some point. So I've got all this fabric over there that needs to be put in my stash. So I didn't want to go mad. The only fabrics that I was really looking for was needle cord. I love needle cord and it's quite hard to get nice patterned needle cord. And when I say nice patterned, there is a lot of lovely florals out there, but I'm not necessarily a floral person. So I said to myself, if I saw some nice cut needle cord, then I would purchase that. But really, that's it. Unless there's something really magical, I'm not getting it. So that was my plan, and everyone laughed at that plan. I'm sure you all did. But actually, I've not done too bad. Let me talk to you about what I got first. So first of all, we stopped off at Becky's Sewing Studio. Now, I had actually heard of this lady because Helen from Stitch Repeat and Angela from Devon Thread Tales, they visited her store at the Exeter craft show last year and did rave about it, but I never checked it out, to be fair. And it was a beautiful shop. The reason why I love it so much is because she loves leopard print too. So some of the fabrics were lovely. Like, the fabrics were lovely. There was unusual fabrics. There were some fabrics that I had in my stash already. And she does all lovely earrings, wooden earrings that are sewing related. I could have gone mad in there, but I was fairly restrained. and I didn't buy any fabric from there until the very end of the show. So initially I purchased some labels, because she actually does her own labels, which is amazing. So I don't know about you, but I get a little bit bored of the labels that are out there. The Kylie Machine ones are lovely. The Little Rosy Cheeks are lovely, but there's not that much choice when it comes to labels. And these are just really nice. So I got these ones that say sewing is my superpower. And I like these because they're black. I don't wear loads of bright, colourful clothes. So I find that the bright, colourful labels, I feel like clash with a lot of the clothes that I make. So I like the black ones. And this one, oh, let me get it out of the packet, actually. Oh, they're big, hefty labels. All right, let's wait for it to go. So there we go. Sewing is my superpower. How lovely is that? And I think you get six in there. So look. Yeah, six labels. And they were £6.50 a packet, or two for £12. And then this one comes in two colourways. And it's in a lovely leopard print. I was not made to be subtle. And I was not made to be subtle. And I think Becky has got these already. And we took a photograph of Becky from What Beck Sews outside of this store, because it was called What Beck Sew. It was called Becky's Studio. I just thought that was really nice. And we got to chat to Becky, and she was really lovely. And she was really nice to chat to, actually. So I purchased those. And then I saw this French terry and loved it. You'll see why in a minute. And it was £8.50, and it's a fleece back French terry, which is an absolute bargain price. So I didn't buy it when we first went in there, but I went back at the end of the show because I still couldn't stop thinking about it. And this is it. So it's a mustard backing with brown, which is really nice. And they're my colours. I love mustard, and you can see the quality of that fleece. It's such a lovely fabric. So I got 2 metres of that, so that was £8, so £17. For that. And the reason why I wanted to get this vlog filmed tonight is this fabric and another fabric are not going into my stash. They are getting washed and made up. So this is going to be a South Bank sweater, because I've never made the South Bank sweater and I really want to. So it's going to be the South Bank sweater dress. And so I'm going to throw this in the wash and get this made up, because it's going to be a lovely cozy jumper. So that was my first, well, not my first fabric purchase, but that was the first one I'm going to show you. The only other two pieces of fabric that I purchased were some remnant pieces that were a needle cord. But obviously I'd gone with in mind that if I saw any nice needle cord, I was going to get it. And I'm just trying to find the label for where I got this from. I can't find it, but if I do find it, I'll put a the name of the shop here. So the first thing that caught my eye was this needle cord, 100% cotton needle cord, and it was a 1 meter piece, and it was £7. And I just love it. It's got a burgundy background with these lilac and like pink hearts. And I got that for another pair of dungarees for Alice. So got that, which was cute. So that was £7. And then she had a 3 meter remnant in exactly the same fabric, but in this olive green. So hopefully that's coming up okay. With light blue, green, mustard. So all my colours. And this was 3 metres for £20. So I thought me and Alice could have something really cute and matching there. So again, that was a needle cord that I was very, very happy with. So to get 4 metres of needle cord for £27, I thought was a very good bargain. So I'm very happy about those. So that was all the fabric that I bought at the Creative Craft Show. I feel like I was very good. Now, Roy from Roy's Material World really tried to get me to buy some fabric, and I was so proud of myself. He was going to do me 5 meters of this gorgeous viscose for 30 quid, but I was so brave. I wasn't brave. I was so strong. I said no, because I literally don't need any more viscose in my stash, and I'm very pleased because I haven't purchased any viscose. So I was very, very happy about that. So yay me. Other things that we're doing over there, we went to the Sewing Street stand, and they were giving away gorgeous bags. Where's my bag? Here it is. So they were giving away free bags. So in this bright pink, and it says you don't have to pay to be part of the club. And it's got a gorgeous little tag that says recycled cotton. I mean, I just thought they were really nice bags. Becky's eyes lit up when she saw these because they were her signature colour. Beautiful. So we all got one of those. And they were doing a tombola. And I went on the tombola. And the woman just before us won the Brother cutting machine, which was amazing. And there's loads of prizes on there. Printers, etc. Big prizes. But I won some vinyl for my cricket, which obviously I haven't unpacked yet. So this is just a grey vinyl. I don't know what to do with it yet. I don't really know what I'll use it for, but that's what I won. So that was a freebie, really. And then while we were there, they had a photo booth, and me, Bex and Shannon went into the photo booth, and I'll insert a picture of the photo. Now, I thought I was being really clever and posing, and I had a pencil. So basically they had these cardboard cutouts that you held up. Bex had the sewing machine and I chose the pencil. I'll put you a picture of it up. Yeah. Slightly embarrassing. I'll leave your imagination to it, but yeah, it looks rude. But anyway, that wasn't my intention. So that was Sewing Street. And then the next few things that I purchased this, which is a textile star kit. Now, I am taking part in a swap on Instagram. It's called the Sew Bauble, being run by the Chorley branch of Sew Confident. I might have got that hashtag wrong, so I'll put it on there. And part of it is to create a bauble for somebody and send it to them. And I thought this might be a nice little gift to send to somebody. So if you're taking part, this might be your gift. Obviously, it's a secret Santa kind of element. But yeah, I just thought this would be really, really nice as my bauble to send to somebody. So yeah, I purchased this. I think it's £8. And you've got everything that you need in there. It's from Wild and Green. You've got step-by-step instructions, pre-cut felt shapes, a sewing needle and pins, stranded embroidery threads, and golden wooden beads. So yeah, hopefully that will look like it does on the front. And they had these dangling around the stall and they look really nice. So I got that. And the next thing that I got was something that just pulled on my heartstrings. I've not really shared about this on the channel, I don't think, before, but I had a sister who sadly passed away, and quite a few years ago now. And I'm a big believer that robins are a sign that a loved one who's passed over into the spirit world is around. And especially at poignant parts of my life as I've been growing up, I always see a robin. And for example, when I got married, on my hen do, there was a robin that followed us around for a good part of our walk that we did on my hen do. We went to Devon and we walked around the beach, and it was like really, really lovely, and there was a robin and it kept following us, and I was definitely believed that that was like the spirit of my sister. And when I got married, the day before my wedding, I stayed over with my girlfriends in the spa hotel, and there was a robin sat outside while I was sat in the spa. I could see through the mirror window. And then the next day when I was having my makeup done, just before my wedding, there was a robin that just appeared on the windowsill. And it was just really, really special having that little memory. Now, whether you believe it or not, I believe it. So, you know, if you don't believe it, you don't need to comment on it. It's fine. But for me personally, that's what I believe. And so whenever I see a robin, it's a really special kind of thing for me. My daughter went to a trip, a school trip last year, and she knows how much robins mean to me. And I don't know if you've ever seen it in my sewing room, but I'll just grab it. She purchased this little robin that was like a pottery robin that she saw, and just purchased it for me. And this sits in my room, and it's kind of like my little reminder of my sister. So anyway, long story short, sorry about that. Let's cheer this up a bit. I saw this cross stitch, and I'm going to try and zoom in, and it's a robin, and it basically says, robins appear when loved ones are near, and I just absolutely love it. And it just really pulled on my heartstrings, and you know I've got a bit of a love-hate relationship with cross stitch. I want to love it, but I just get stuck. But I thought this would be a really nice one, and I just saw it as a bit of a sign, so I got that. It was £15. And it's from Hetty's Crafty Collections, and yeah, I just think that'd be really nice. I think I want to get it made up and hang it in my sewing room, my little robin wall. So yeah, that's why robins are really special to me. The next few couple of things that I got was from the Italian Buttons, which is a really reasonably priced button company that are at all of these shows. I got the same button in the different sizes, so I got the larger buttons, which are like gold with this like pearlized effect. I got the next size, which I think might be, I don't know, is it the 15mm? And then I got the shirt buttons as well, just because they're plain, but with a little bit of pizzazz. And they were £1.50 a pack, so that's just really good value. And then they're also selling the dungaree sets in gold, £1.50 and £2. I've just purchased Kylie the Machine ones, and they were not that cheap. So there's that as well. And then the other couple of things that I got were purely just earrings. So obviously Bex was with us, so she makes her own earrings, and her company is called Jazz and Wow. And she makes resin earrings, but obviously she was really interested in looking at other people's earrings. And this was a little company called Catrally, might be saying that wrong, but these are polymer clay ones, and I just saw these and I just really like them. They've got little stars and they're moons in purple with gold flecks in. So I got those. I think they were £6 or £8. And then the final pair of earrings that I got was from a little company called KJ Day, and again, polymer clay earrings. And I could have purchased about 3 pairs of these, but these were them, and I just really like these. So yeah, got those, and yeah, they were £6. And they're in the mustard colours that I really like. I also purchased some cupcakes. They've all been eaten, so I can't show you those. But they were lovely. And that is my haul from the Creative Craft Show. Now, we wrapped up there about 2 o'clock. Now, Stitch Fabrics, who you know I love, I buy a lot of fabric from them, they were not at the show. And I knew this because they were doing a pop-up shop at the Methodist Church in Solihull, which they did a few months ago. And Shannon and Bex were quite keen to go. Now, they'd message in the morning saying, shall we go there first before we go to the Creative Craft? And I was like, no, let's go to the craft show. And I was really strong. And then when we got there in the morning, they were like, oh, it's probably best we haven't gone. And then I said, well, if we have enough time, we can go later on, because Bex had never been. So we finished at 2, and they were like, oh, have we got time to go? And I was like, yeah, we probably have, let's go. So I drove Shannon, because Shannon caught the train, and Bex followed us. And we got there, and oh my God, there were so many nice fabrics. I could have purchased about 20, okay, I'm exaggerating. I could have purchased probably about 10 fabrics there. There was a few gorgeous ones, and if I can find the picture on the website, I'll show you, but there was a jacquard, black jacquard with tigers on. So there's a black jacquard linen with tigers on, and oh, it's panels, and it was gorgeous, but it's £20 a panel. And I think you'd need more than one panel. There was some gorgeous silks. There was 2 viscoses. That one was green with butterflies on, which had ladybugs as well. And then there's another one that was kind of like abstract butterflies and a greeny mustard. Could have purchased both of those. And there was a wool, but I didn't buy any of those. And I did try and be good. Now, I initially wasn't going to buy anything, but I did. We all knew I would. But I'm happy with my purchases. So the first one that I purchased was a John Caldor jersey. And it's this one. It's on a beige background with an abstract black print. And it's a John Caldor and I got 2.5 meters of this, and it was £6 a meter. And this is going to be some kind of just jersey dress, or maybe a sirocco actually. So that was that one. And then this one was, it just kept catching my eye, and I was just like, oh, it's so quirky. And then this lady next to me went, it's weird, which I was a bit like, well, I like it. And then I think she thought, well, she's offending me. But when someone says something's weird, it makes me want to buy it more. And there was only a meter left, and it's a £20 a meter. It's from some designer, you know, Berkman. Oh, what's that designer store in New York called? I can't remember, but anyway. I'll put it there anyway. But this was for some collections that go in that store, which is a very high-end store in New York. But it just caught my eye anyway. And this year, it was just over a meter left. So maybe a skirt or a pinafore or something. But I just really liked it. And this is it. So it's on a purple, like a burgundy background. Colours are coming up quite well. It's got this little like Japanese looking girl on it. I think Japanese, like, oh, what's that kind of, I can't think what it's called. Anime. So it's got these like little Japanese like anime girls on it, kind of weeping, but I just loved it. And I'm thinking maybe, I've only got a meter, so I could make the Camden skirt by, who is it by? I mean, I don't know how much you need for the Camden pinafore, but that would look gorgeous with a like turtleneck underneath. That's what I'm thinking might work well for that. But yeah, it's basically, God, you can go, that's the reverse. But yeah, so he did me that for £15 because it was £20 a meter and it was the last one, last bit of the roll. So he let me have that. And I just think that's really quirky. I'm not going to see anybody else in this weird, as the lady said, fabric. But yeah, I love it. Love it, love it, love it. And then the final fabric I blame Becky for. So Becky's also purchased this, spoiler alert. This fabric's been going around quite a lot. It's a dead stock from Ralph Lauren. And Guthrie Garney had it in stock for a while. So did Beyond the Pink Door. And I resisted both those times. But it's such a lovely needle cord that when you see it in the flesh, Bex purchased 2 metres of it, or 2.5 metres. And I decided to jump on the bandwagon and I did the same. And I know exactly what I'm going to make with this. I'm going to make the Penelope dress, which I actually wore to the show. And I always get so many compliments. I'll put a picture of one of them in. But it's for Christmas. And it's this fabric. So it's this gingham plaid, whatever you want to call it, and then it's got these little teddy bears, all Christmas themed, with like Santa hats. That's probably a better one to show you. So he's skiing, you've got a Santa hat here. Sorry, I'm not doing a very good job of showing you this. And it's such a super fine needle cord. I mean, it's very hard to tell that it's a needle cord really, but it is. And I think that would just be lovely. I've been dying to make a needle cord version of the Penelope dress. And initially I was going to use that heart fabric, but now I feel like this is going to be it. So for every single fabric I've got, there is a plan for. Possibly this one I'm a bit unsure about, but a sirocco would be a good shout actually. So they are my purchases. So I didn't do that well. I didn't buy any fabric, but fabric I have done was very more considered than I usually am. So it's progress over perfection, as I say. My stash is ever growing, but I plan to do a lot of sewing over the next few days. So that was my haul. I had a fabulous time with the ladies again. So it was all the shout outs to the lovely ladies. Sarah, I'm going to miss one now. Jenny's dad. Hi, Jenny's dad. Donna, Ruth, Shannon, Becky. And me, I think that was it. Please don't let me say I've forgotten anybody. But yeah, it was really, really good. I really enjoyed it. It's not the kind of place to go if you're just a sewer. If you're going there to just fabric shop after fabric shop, it's not like that. It's just a lot of different cute gifts. I also bought John a little gift for his birthday, and it was just a little Man United kind of wall hanging thing. I'm not going to bore you with the details because I'm sure you don't care. Because his birthday's on Sunday and mine is on Tuesday. So yeah, that's it, I suppose. So I hope you've enjoyed this little haul. I'll try and link everybody that I got my fabrics from in the comments below. If you've liked this channel, if you've liked this vlog, please click the like button. Hopefully you're not sick of me showing you my fabric yet. If you don't subscribe already, please get the subscribe button. I really would love to get to 5,000 subscribers before Christmas. I'm not sure I'm going to get there now, but it's you know, it would be nice to get there. And if you want to support my channel further, you can always buy me a coffee using my coffee account link, which is in the notes below. And if you want to follow me on Instagram, I'm over on Instagram under Sofa Serenity. Right then, I'll leave it there. I am off to wash some of this fabric and I'll see you all soon. Happy sewing. Bye.